pray for the world that you created and love. We pray for peace on earth, but know that for many there is no peace. And so today we remember all of those who suffer the ravages of warfare and violence of all kinds. And let us pray in silence for the poor, the marginalized, the sick, the lonely, the unloved, the aged, and the little children. God, who came among us as one for whom there was no room at the inn, we pray for all of those who feel shut out, rejected, and alone. Bring comfort, health, and healing to families living in refugee camps, elderly in nursing homes, children in foster care, and homeless people here in our neighborhood and throughout our city and world. And now let us pray in silence for leaders everywhere whose decisions affect the welfare of our communities, nations, and world. God of every nation, we pray for our president and decision makers in every branch of government, here and throughout the world. Guide them with a vision of justice, peace, and compassion, especially for the most vulnerable and victimized among us. These prayers we humbly offer to God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, using now the words which Christ taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Be seated.
Service of lessons and carols. And now let us stand and sing together, Angels We Have Heard on High.
done this and have not withheld your son, your only son, I will indeed bless you, and I will make your offspring as numerous as the stars of the heaven and as the sand that is on the seashore. And your offspring shall possess the gain of their enemies, and by your offspring shall all the nations of the earth gain blessings for themselves, because you have obeyed my voice. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. peace that Christ will bring is foreshown. A shoot shall come out of the stock of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. His delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see, or decide by what his ears hear. But with righteousness he shall judge the poor, and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. The wolf shall live with the lamb, the leopard shall lie down with the kid, the calf and the fatling and the lion together, and a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze, their young shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the asp, and the weaned child shall put its hand on the adder's den. They will not hurt or destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. the angel Gabriel salutes the Virgin Mary. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called the Son of God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be to me according to your word." Then the angel
In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn. Thanks be to God.
As we listen to the next carol, the ushers will come forward and we will receive our morning offering.
Suddenly, There was with the angels a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those who he favors. When the angel had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us. So they went with haste and found Mary and
wise men are led by the star to Jesus. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem to be born, they told him, in Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, and you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people, Israel. Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, go and search diligently for the child. And when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage. When they had heard the king, they set out, and there, ahead of them, went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Please stand for the gospel reading. John unfolds the great mystery of the incarnation. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him. Yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. The Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. Thanks be to God.
And the Word was with God.
Let us pray. In this most holy season, we have gathered, O God, to celebrate the birth of the Christ child, to join our voices with the choirs of angels, to come with shepherds to the stable and wonder at this Christmas miracle. Yet we have not forgotten to bring the hurt and hopes of our world, remembering all who struggle, who suffer, who grieve, who feel alone and without hope. Now strengthen each of us to embrace and to show forth the love of Christ until your peaceable kingdom comes on earth as it is in heaven. And we pray in the name of Emmanuel, God.